What's good out there, everyone? It's Roll Easy here, back again with another video today, and this one is gonna be all about them gold bricks, all right? I have another location of 2 gold bricks for you guys to find in Red Dead Redemption 2, and we're gonna get into this, all right? So basically, right now, this is me in story mode, and I'm gonna show you on the map the first location that we need to go to. Okay, we need to meet a man named Maximo, and most of you probably have not met him yet because he's a little ways down. You probably didn't just randomly run into him, but this is the exact location, all right? And I'm showing you really clearly on the map because I actually was told by a subscriber last video that I wasn't showing the map fully, so I want to make sure that you guys can actually see the exact location, okay? Just make sure there's no confusion there. So that's the location that we're going to, and I'm gonna go ahead and go into cinematic mode, and we'll skip forward to when I actually get there. So here we are. You'll know that you're in the right place as well because you'll see that big cliff right there, all right? It's not like a massive cliff, but just like a little cliff in a valley. So you want to go to the top of this cliff right here, and this is where you will find Maximo. You'll see him there kind of talking to himself, a little drunk, and his horse, all right? And he's actually going to call you over to speak to him. So once you go and speak to him, he's just going to start talking about a few random things, but he's the main thing that you really need from him is you need the map. We need to buy the first map off of him, okay? And what he's going to do, he's just going to begin to speak to us about the Jack Hall gang, and, you know, Arthur's going to say that he knows, you know, of them and stuff, and this man is going to attempt to sell us a map with their hidden treasure before they perished that they were never able to actually get back. And apparently you need 2 maps, okay, according to this guy. So the first map he has, and this one will lead us to the second one, but he's gonna try to sell this to you for $10, okay? So as you can see in the subtitles, you can't hear it, but in the subtitles, you're actually gonna see that he's gonna offer us $10 right there for the map. Now, if you guys wanna save $5, this is why I included this in the video. Go ahead and decline his offer first, okay? So as you can see right there on the bottom right, I can decline. You want to decline his offer. Look at the subtitles. He's basically going to want, he just wants to get rid of this, okay? He wants to get rid of this, so he's going to offer it to us for $5, as you can see right down there, okay? And then this is when you want to accept it, all right? Don't decline it again, because I really don't think he's gonna leave, you know, with any less than $5. So yeah, go ahead and pay him the $5, and now we have our first map. Nice and easy, okay? And nice and cheap, all right? $5 ain't too much. Especially if you found those gold bricks already in a couple videos back that I made. So we have the very first map, and this map is going to lead us over to the second one. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and skip to that part. I'm going to press pause and show you the exact location on the map. All right, so it's not too far from our location right now. As you can see, it's right there, all right, above the N in New. And it's right by Caliban's seat. Okay, it's a prime hunting spot for rabbits, apparently. So yeah, we're gonna make our way over there right now, and you will come across this little area where you're kind of in the middle of 2 little, you know, uphill slants, and you wanna make your way up this one, okay? As you can see, this is what it looks like. You wanna just run all the way up. Yeah, not really much to say about this, but yeah, just run up, and once you get to this point, you wanna start looking towards your right, and you'll see that you can actually start headed down. There's a couple little downward slants here. So you don't want to go to this one where you just see bushes. There's one that's a little bit more open ahead. There we go. This is the one you want to go down. So be careful here. Don't run. Don't sprint. You don't want to fall off here because you'll probably die. This is where you do want to sprint though. You need to sprint here and then jump really quickly to actually land right there. Okay, so we're on this little platform. We're good. No need to go down there. Just climb straight up. Okay, you'll see another little rock there. Climb up and you can fall down right over here. And this is actually where the next map is. So right at this point where it looks like there's nowhere to go because there really isn't, look to your left. And then if you need to squat down, if you don't, you'll see right there, you're allowed to search. And now he'll search in there and he should find the second map. Okay, so there's the second map right there in that little crevice on this hill. So here we go. We found the Jack Hall gang treasure. That would be the second clue. Okay, so we're gonna move on right now to the next one. Now, at this point, I was trying to look at the map, and for some reason, it wasn't letting me. So some of the controls are still a little finicky with this game, all right? It definitely needs to be touched up a bit. But yeah, this is gonna be the next location. I'm gonna show you on the map right here, Katora Springs. So you wanna set the waypoint right on the O, all right, in Katora Springs. That's the map fully zoomed out and now fully zoomed back in. So set your waypoint right at that O, basically at the bottom right of it, and we're gonna head to that exact spot right now. And what you should see is kind of an open field. Kind of looks like it's volcanic. I mean, there's geysers and stuff like that. It's actually really nice. I had never been to this location before actually, you know, searching for this treasure map. So, yeah, we finally found it. This is the location. There's geysers up ahead. This is the exact spot. I'm going to show you a kind of 360 view what it looks like. You're going for this pile of rocks. So it's the second pile of rocks from the left. All right, and there's a little crevice in here as well that you need to reach into. So just keep walking around until you find it. It's right there. You can actually see that there's a little piece of paper in there. So you can search. It's actually right in there. So we're going to pull in and reach it out. And this was actually supposed to be the last clue or the reward. If you saw right there at on the right of the screen, you actually get $15 for this. So I got 15 bucks for this. And Arthur's thinking, wow, I got what I paid for. I only made 10 bucks basically. But believe it or not, that is not the very end of it. There is one more location after this. So I'm going to show you that location here on the map after I'm done getting all these unlocks and trophies. All right, there we go. More stamina. I feel like my stamina is always going up. But yeah, so this is the final location right here. So I'm riding here on my horse, and I'm going to press pause real quick to show you the exact spot that's actually on the map. So here we go. It's right over here. O'Cree's Run, seems like, or O'Cree's Run is what this little kind of lake or pond is called. This is zoomed out on the map. This is the exact location that you want to be going to. Okay, so right now we're on land, but there's a little island. You see where I set my waypoint? That's where we need to go to, that little island. So I can actually keep going forward here a little bit. I'll just take my horse as far as I can. And guys, take your horse in water, all right? That definitely does help. You want to clean your horse up and stuff. Feed them, do all that. You really do. This game is so detailed, it's amazing. But people notice when your horse is dirty and your horse's health starts going down a little bit when it gets too dirty, where it goes down faster. So that is that little island of rocks that we waypointed on the map. So you want to just swim your way over there. And I'm assuming that swimming, you can get faster at swimming because this looks very slow and I'm like tapping the hell out of X right now. But yeah, I need to look into swimming more. So once you get to this little island, walk up a little bit. You should get the examine or search option in the bottom right. And then just go ahead and hold the X button on PlayStation. That would be square on PlayStation, X on Xbox. And there you go. You should find 2 gold bricks just like that. 2 gold bars. And we have found the hidden treasure. So that's $1,000 worth of gold bricks that we just found, 500 apiece. Plus the $15 that you made from the last treasure. So $1,015 you can make very easily by following this video. Okay? But yeah, that's going to be it for me, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. My name is Roll Easy. Please subscribe to the channel if you're brand new by hitting that big red button. Turn on post notifications and drop a fat like on this video and the rest of my videos for the freshest and the most informative RDR2 content out. Peace.